Very good morning, my dear students. Today is Sunday and November 19, 2017. On this Sunday, you know very well that in the this is the leisure day, and when we get to revise all the things whatever you have read in the week. In the Hindu newspaper on the Sunday analysis, definitely there are some leisure time also that you should go to the non-fiction side, some of the articles, some of the storylines. They are also good because they will develop a foundation for you. Some of the news are important. Let us get a recapitulation of the news, whatever has been discussed in the today's newspaper. In today's newspaper, that this news that imagine there is no country, there is a person who, as per the treaty signed between India and Bangladesh, he was given the citizenship status, but he is having some problems. Definitely, this type of the problem, sometimes when it is being discussed, it is a time to revise the Indo-Bangladesh, this type of the citizenship status, some of the islands which has gone to Bangladesh, some of the islands which is likely to come to India. What are the provisions existing there, in which part of the constitution we are dealing with that one, that requires your revision. This news that winners of WAAD Asia Awards Women in Arts, Architecture and Design, the short form of this one, that is an advertisement type of the news is there. It is not important. Some of the, you should not get confused by that. It is announced by the government or some good big organizations are there, and this is not at all important from the civil services perspective. Open defecation programs, that is the important aspect in which some of the data, whatever you have written related to open defecation programs, please revise it. And the government is claiming some of the things, but my dear students, please don't go by this only. You should have the data what are available in your in the earlier classes. That is more important for you, because this type of the advertisements has lost little bit significance at present. So yes, but yes, seven states, Union Territories made ODF. This is important. 230 districts become ODF. The declarations part are there. 2.7 lakh, this one, but these two data that provided access to toilets and this one. At this place, you take a little bit of pinch of salt. But yes, there are sufficient changes are there. Government claims is there, but the people access to the toilets at that point, we have to take little bit analytical viewpoints also, because it is related with the behavioral change. Access to the toilets, making toilets on paper and actual access to the toilets, these are the different type of the situations. Manmohan Singh wins Indira Gandhi Peace Prize. That is little bit important, because this can be linked that in which field it is being given. It is being given for the peace, disarmament and development. Peace, disarmament and development. That can be a little bit of importance, but as such not that important. Here in this news that the lowdown on the dengue epidemic. Some aspects are very important, and my dear students, UPSC may quizzically test you on certain aspects. They can ask you that what is antibody dependent enhancements. This word has been used here, antibody dependent enhancements. This is required to be understood. How many types of the serotypes are there, and what is the antibody dependent enhancement, see, this phenomenon is there. This is a very important aspect from our exam point of view, that yes, dengue, H1N1 virus. From these aspects, the questions are usually being asked. So please, my dear students, have a good reading of this portion up to from here to this one. So this is important. Let me explain it to you for your convenience. UPSC may ask very simple questions that in which disease this antibody dependent enhancements has come more in news. This way also they can ask, and they can complicate it also that antibody dependent enhancements in this context which statements are true. You should understand that this is related to dengue, very much you know. The dengue thrives in the urban habitats, but at present there are certain casualties which are in the dengue, and that is related to antibody dependent enhancements. The dengue virus has four types. The types are four, not one. These are the dengue, D, E, N, V1 and the same way the DEN V2, DEN V3, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, this is very important. These are the, when a person is affected by one dengue type, suppose he is infected with the dengue 1. Dengue 1 serotype, that is the serotype of the there. Serotype is what? You know it very well that the dengue like the antigens. They are coming in our body, these are the antigens. So serotypes are the types of the antigens. There are four types of the antigens. These are the characteristics of the dengue virus. Flavivirus, about which we have read a lot in our earlier classes. Flavivirus. So I will not revise that one. Only the important aspect I am telling, that these are the four types of the virus. And suppose a person is infected by one serotype of the dengue virus, then the antibodies are generated against this type 1. Suppose DNV1 one is affected by that, then antibody against this one will be generated, and this will give an immunity to the person against this type of dengue only, not against these three types. Mind it, dear students. So this is important aspect that you have to understand. So which protect itself from the rest of the life only against DNV1. If the same person is then infected by the other serotype like the DNV2 or DNV3, DNV4, like that, then this becomes the antibody dependent enhancement, because the disease will be now more severe. Very peculiar circumstances, no? That now the person, suppose another time in next season the dengue 2 is there, then it is a very critical case. And this critical case is the antibody dependent enhancements, because earlier he had suffered with DNVN. Next year he is having DNV2, then it is antibody dependent enhancements. Means the antibody which has been developed due to DNV1, it makes the conditions even more critical. It is not protecting. So they may give you that it will worsen. It will worsen the second infection instead of protecting against it. That is the antibody dependent enhancement. So in this condition, how does it worsen? That is this causes dengue hemorrhagic fever. Hemo means blood, no? Hemorrhagic fever means hemo means blood, and rhagic means the blood capillaries, there will be rupture of the blood capillaries. The severe dengue hemorrhagic fever causes blood vessels to leak, rupture, which lead to loss of the blood pressure, and if these are not treated quickly, the patient will die. It will be very difficult for the patients to save. So if they have to be, the body fluids require to be replaced very fast, and the doctors must be trained to understand that yes, the person is having this type of the dengue hemorrhagic fever because it is secondary infection and antibody dependent enhancement second time infection. Second aspect is that the vaccine has been created. India has claimed that they have introduced, they have discovered, they have introducing the world's first dengue vaccine. The name of the dengue vaccine is DENG, dengue vaccine. So this is also one important thing you must note it, because in the exam they may ask in the statement type of the questions only, that which statement is true for the dengue. So studies show that people who have never been exposed to dengue can develop severe disease if they get dengue a few years after vaccination. So after vaccination, if this serotype, another serotype is there, then this may also be problematic. So proper study has to be done, that this is thought to be due to ADF, this one antibody dependent enhancement. So if this dengue vaccine is also being given, if the second time that infection is there, then also the same type of problems will happen. So from that perspective, that this news is important. This news that Bangladesh regarding the social news that she is telling, the Silvana Sinha, a Bangladesh social entrepreneur, she is telling that yes, Bangladesh health indicators have been better in most better than most of the South Asia for years. It is very interesting that in the Pratyasen's book on Certain Glory, you have read that Bangladesh is going leaps and bounds and doing very good in the health sector. But yes, the lady is telling that there are not very good hospitals in Bangladesh. This all is due to because in the primary health center type of the units are working in the rural areas. But this required to be proliferated more and there should be more specialized centers also. So from that perspective, this news is important. I am finding that in Asia, a path for cleaner air, it is required, it is important for your Asia point of view. Some very few facts are there. So I think that not much news there from the civil services perspective, but yes, you must revise. My dear students, today you must notice that some of the students who have subscribed our channels, magnusis.com, our website, they have been given the Ancient India. The test series of the Ancient India is there on the 23rd. So your revision work for the Ancient India must be complete. Besides those students, some of the students have been given the homework for the physiographic division of India and as well as that the drainage system of India, drainage and physiographic division of India. So please go to all the videos of this one and definitely a test will be there. And on 23rd, there will be no excuse. The test will be for the last 1 week. Whatever the news analysis was there up to today, means up to 19th. And then these two things are there. So please go be very regular. And with this methodology, if you prepare, then your chances of getting selections are very bright.